Ain't that right? I know y'all ain't never been on the streets, but I'm saying that's where it is. You go do your thing, and you with your boys over at that table, long as you don't mess with me, you can have all the good time that you want. I'm not gonna help your good time.
All right.
I'm not gonna contribute to nothing that you doing over there. But I don't care what you do. Am I right? And I don't care how you got home or get home or nothing else about you. Cause I'm there to have a good time for who? For me. I'm not concerned about you. As long as they provide what I need, I'm all right. If y'all don't like it, y'all go home. But that's not the way Paul says we ought to be in the Christian community. The Christians got to be caring about one another. What he said, that we fulfill his joy by being like-minded. But what does it mean to be like-minded? That mean we all going to think alike? No. We're not going to all think alike. We're not gonna see things the same way. But we are unified through the God that is in us. That means you don't have to think like me, and that's not going to bother me. Because sometimes I go your way and sometimes you go my way. But it don't matter which way we go as long as we get where we're trying to get. Is that right? And I don't know about y'all, but I'm trying to get to a place where there ain't going to be no more lying and no more dying.
All right, now.
No more fighting, no more struggles. There ain't going to be no more of that stuff. That's what I'm trying to get.
Yeah.
And if you got Christ in you, that's where you ought to be trying to get to.
Right.
And the Word of God needs to be dwelling in you and guiding you that way. And you can't be loving God without loving your neighbor.
Yes, sir.
It's just not possible. Be on one accord. We don't want a car. That means we're here for the same reason. I'm not here because somebody made me come. Huh? I'm not here because I didn't have nothing else to do. I'm not here because I feel some sort of guilt or shame. I'm here because I want to come and worship God for what he's done for me.
Amen. Amen.
And he saved me, so I want to do all I can to help somebody else.
Amen.
And the best way that you can help anybody is to show them love.
Amen.
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And listen, you can't put yourself before them and show them love.
All right, say that. Yeah.
Because you come here with a, like me today, with a bad tooth, you know, I'm be thinking about me.
All right.
Get somebody else to preach today, my tooth is hurting. It broke last night. Amen. But the less I think about that too, the more I can think about what God has me to do.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. And God's going to see me through whatever he wants me to do.
Amen.
You know, that's some folk that you just have a hard time loving.
Come on now.
Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Right. Some folk, you know, you know, let me say it the way we are. I just don't like them. God said, you don't have to like them.
Amen.
But you need to love them. Now, don't look over their faults, but show them love. If you showing them love, can you look at their faults too? No. I love you in spite of the way you act, in spite of the way you do. I know that's where you divide the line. Man. Now, the line becomes when he says, look out not only on your things, but esteem others greater than you. Now that's crossing the line. Ain't Paul crossing the line? But Paul says that you need to consider other people before you consider yourself. Is that crossing the line, y'all? In other words, if there's a quarter of a chicken and I'm hungry, I need to make sure you get something to eat before I do.
Amen.
That's a mess, ain't it?
Amen.
But that's what the word says.
All right.
You know what happens when you do that? God knows that you trust him and he'll take care of you.
Amen.
If you're looking out for somebody else, God will always make sure you have more than what you need. A lot of us are struggling today because we try to hoard everything we get.
Right.
We won't do as God has told us to do. So we always struggling. Eh? Always struggling. Because God has said you need to trust me. Don't be holding on to everything you get, and the simple stuff. Some of us can't show no love toward nobody. I know it's not manly to love another brother, but God said you need to love your brother.
All right.
Now, we need to know what kind of love God's talking about. They ain't talking about y'all go lay down in the bed somewhere together.
Amen.
Not that kind of love.
Come on.
We get twisted.
Yes, we do.
Amen. On these material things as opposed to spiritual things. When we have the love of God in us, we need to love everybody.
Yes,
and God said you need to love your brother before you love yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of them have trouble loving other folks because we don't love ourselves, ain't that right? I got a secret for you. If you don't love yourself, you got the love of God is not in you. God said you need to love him with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. How you going to love God if you don't love your...
All right.
God is love. Is that right?
Yes, he is.
Well, maybe if we thought about it for a moment, if we considered that all that we have, all that we are, comes from the Lord, we can put the love of others before the love of ourselves.
Mm.
Because if you don't have the love of God, you ain't got nothing. Is that right?
Right.
Paul says then we need to, as Christians, have a Christian mind.
Yeah.
So we need to stop looking at things the way we always looked at them.
Amen.
Y'all know what that means? Mm. That means, you know, you grew up on the streets of dog-eat-dog world, strong survive. You got to stop looking at things that same way.
All right now.
You have become a child of God. Mm-hmm. Now, when I was a child, I lived to my parents to take care of me. Mm-hmm. Even when I got in trouble, ain't that right?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all maybe ain't never been in no trouble, but I got in some trouble, and I went running to Mama.
Mm-hmm.
And Mama always took care of me. I may have got a whooping because I did that, but she going to take care of me first.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't that right?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of us, we get old and we still got our parents, and we need a meal, where do we go? Might not take nothing over there, but we always go over there and eat. But Mama's going to take care of you. Ain't that right? If you go show up hungry, Mama's going to feed you. Am I right?
Amen.
Well, if God is our Father, ain't that right? Then we know that we can go to him for whatever that we may need.
All right.
When we get hungry, he'll feed us.
Amen.
When we get broke, he'll give us a little something to spend.
Yeah.
When we ain't got no love in our life, he'll love us. What does the Bible say? When your mother and your father forsake you, then the Lord will take you up.
Yes,
he will. So we need to maybe start trying to learn and do what the Lord wants us to do. All this struggling that we're doing, all this stuff that we trying to get, we look around and trying to build relationships, but they get strained because we're more interested in what we want for us. Amen. You think about it. If you ever had a girlfriend or a boyfriend, and all you thought about was what was good for you, how long did that girlfriend or boyfriend stay with you? What long was it? But now, in Christ Jesus, we're brothers and sisters. Ain't that right? And you know, folk will tell you most about yourself is your brother or your sister.
That's right.
Ain't that right? When you get wrong, they're going to tell you, I don't care you are my brother, I'm going to tell you wrong. That's why we stay away from my relatives. Yep. We know they're no brothers. we might run in for a minute on the family reunions, but we see somebody, you know, Sister Mary or whoever it was, who always was reaching the Bible. You got all the way from them as quick as you could. Because they don't tell you the truth.
Amen.
Like my grandmother, when I got divorced the first time, that's the only way she identified me. Every time I went around, you know how she did, oh, you the one don't like wives. She knew my name, but because I'm named after one of my sons. But I was identified as the one that didn't like wives because I got a divorce. But in that day, they didn't get divorces. They stuck it out. So when grandmother come around, I made her last stop on my thing. I'm going to make sure everybody went and hugged her and got on the way. I'll make her laugh because she wouldn't embarrass me in front of everybody. Because she going to sell it like it was.
Amen.
And when we are in the family of God, we need to be around people that will tell us like it is.
All right.
Amen.
Not only that, they'll do it out of love. They ain't going to tell you like where you're acting and where you are, Father. No, they're going to tell you where it is. Come on, boy, get some of this peach coffee. But you know you've been wrong, don't you? Amen. So Paul wants us to develop that kind of love, that unity in